Okay, math 2400, lecture 16, continuous random variables 4. Exponential distribution. So we say that random variable x has exponential distribution with parameter lambda if its PDF is this thing. If x is lambda e to the power minus lambda t for t bigger than equal to 0 and 0 otherwise. So it looks like this. It is 0, 0, 0, 0 up to this point. Then it is lambda and it goes down to 0. So it can model lots of things, and one of them is like a human, say, age, for example. You can say x is how much you last, or something that, I mean, like a light bulb, for example, how many hours does it last, or will it last more than, say, certain number of hours, so something like that, and it can be applied to anything that in time, say, something happens. So let's find the two things. First of all, it's expected value, and then it's variance. So expected value is this. Let me try to find it for you. So ex, remember that was a integral from minus infinity to infinity x of x dx, and that is since it's zero. Before zero, so we have zero to infinity, x lambda e to power minus lambda t dt. X dot t. There is no difference. That's just on variance. So, so I can write this lambda outside, and zero infinity x e power minus lambda x dx. So using integration by parts, I have this thing. But let me write it first. I have x, and this thing is in fact differential of minus one over lambda e to power minus lambda x, right? The derivative of this is this, e to the power minus lambda x. So this will be lambda times, I have minus 1 over lambda x e to the power minus lambda x from 0 to infinity, minus integral from 0 to infinity, x times minus 1 over lambda e to the power minus lambda x. This x would be dx in fact, so it's simply this thing dx. Okay, so that's x u dv equals u u v times dv v du, so that's du. So let's see, well, what happens here? This is in fact, for zero, it will give me zero, because this is zero, this is whatever, that's also that's one, for example. Then, what happens for infinity? We have x over e to the power lambda x as x goes to infinity. If we use L'Hopital, we will get limit as x goes to infinity. On top, I have one. Here, I have lambda e to the power lambda x, and that is zero. So this guy here, as x goes to infinity, is zero. So this whole thing is zero. Nothing stays here. Now I have minus minus, so I have a plus one over lambda, and there's also another lambda here. So that lambda and this lambda, they cancel out, and I have minus one over lambda e to the power minus lambda x from zero to infinity. So that all remains. So I have infinity, then e to the power minus infinity is 0. So I have 0 plus 1 over lambda. So it's simply 1 over lambda. Okay. So mu of x, or the expected value of x, in fact, is 1 over lambda. So let's erase this thing and write it somewhere here. So by using integration by parts, we found that this is in fact 1 over lambda. Now, what's its variance? Variance of x. I need e of x squared. I have e of x. So I need this. So e of x squared is integral from minus, well, let's just write from 0 to infinity because we know that it's. And I have x squared times lambda e to the power minus lambda x dx. Right? So again, I write it as 0 infinity x 0 d of minus 1 over lambda e to the power minus lambda x, and that is, and there's a lambda outside, so I have a lambda outside times, I have x squared times. Times minus 1 over lambda e to the power minus lambda x from 0 to infinity. At 0 it's 0, but at infinity I have to find this limit of x squared over e to the power lambda x as x goes to infinity. So after two derivatives I have 2 here, and here I have lambda squared e to the power lambda x. As x goes to infinity, this is 0. So this guy here is again 0. In fact, you can see that e to the power x has every power of x. That's like an infinite polynomial with every power of x. So it definitely dominates any polynomial in the numerator. Not just x squared, x to 10 million, that also dominates that. So this limit for any polynomial up there is 0. So minus integral 0 infinity, and then this is minus 1 over lambda e to the power minus lambda x. Derivative of this will be 2x dx. Derivative of this is 2x dx. So okay, so this one is 0, and that one will give me lambda and lambda, they cancel out, and I have 2x, so I have integral from 0 to infinity, and am I missing something here? So lambda and lambda cancel out. Two x e to the power minus lambda x dx. Let me double check and see if I'm. I think that's correct. So 2x e to the power minus lambda x, and. So, I don't think I can make any mistake. Yeah, I'm doing it on the fly. So, let me check. I haven't written this down anywhere, so I'm just trying to see if I am doing it correctly. So, the lambda comes out, and I have x squared, and that's d, blah, blah, and then I have d of x squared is 2x dx, and so. There's a minus 1 over lambda, so this minus minus is plus, and this lambda with this lambda, they cancel out. Okay, so I have 2 of that, and what was this integral? Remember, integral from 0 to infinity x lambda e to the power minus lambda x dx was in fact this, right? Okay. Now look at this. What is missing here? There's a lambda missing. So this will give me, that will is 2. Okay? 2. So this also gives me the integral from 0 to infinity. X e to the power minus lambda x dx. If I divide by lambda, I will get 1 over lambda squared. So I have 2, there's a 2 here, times 1 over lambda squared. Okay, that's it. So this thing is, in fact, 2 over lambda squared. Okay, so let me erase this and, let's write this here. 2 over lambda squared. So E x squared is 2 over lambda squared. So this will be 2 over lambda squared minus 1 over lambda squared. So that's 1 over lambda squared. So variance is also, variance is 1 over lambda squared, which gives me standard deviation of 1 over lambda. So the So sigma, which is that, is then 1 over lambda. So sigma and mu are both 1 over lambda. Okay. So let's also find the CDF of this function. The CDF also is quite nice. So let me So the CDF fx, remember that was from 0 to say x, for example, and that was lambda e to the power minus lambda t dt. So that is minus e to the power minus lambda t from 0 to x. So that's minus e to the power minus lambda x. Plus 1. So that is 1 minus e to the power minus lambda x. So that's the CDF. And this is in fact for x bigger than or equal to 0. And before that it is 0. So we can say that this fx is 0 and then it starts going up to and goes to, as x goes to infinity, you see this goes to 0 and it goes to 1. So it definitely satisfies what. So it looks like this. Fx. So let's write it as t because we are dealing with time most often. So 1 minus e to the power minus lambda t, where t bigger than or equal to 0, and it is 0 for t less than 0. Okay. You can recognize this thing, and this is a very nice function, so it looks like this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, then it goes up, and it has an asymptote at 1. So it gets closer and closer to 1, which is in fact the case. It goes to 1. If t goes to 1 and t goes to infinity, that was a property of CDF. Now there's also another thing which is interesting here. So most often we are, when it comes to age of something or duration, how should I say that? Yeah, age of something, we are interested finding the probability that something lasts more than certain age, right? So that is in fact this. That is p of say x bigger than t, right? So this is 1 minus p of x less than or equal to t. So 1 minus e to the power minus lambda t, right? That was the fx. So that's e to the power minus lambda t. That's interesting. So as you see, as t gets larger and larger, you see that it goes to 0 almost. So what is this? Well, in terms of area under the curve, let me erase this and So like if you are doing some insurance, you're like an insurance, say, actuary, for example, then if this is time t, say, then this is a probability that x, say, dies. For example, if we say dying or damage or something, whatever, something dies. Before h t, so that's probability that it dies from 0 to t, I mean in this period of time. So this is this problem. But we are not interested in this. This is interesting. This is interesting. P of x is bigger than t. The probability that someone lasts more than 100 years, say. Okay, so if you are selling life insurance, then that becomes increasingly important to see that. There's also another thing which is increasingly important. It is, say, somebody is like 60, say, and then you ask this, given that he is 60, what is the probability that he lasts more than like 85 years? So that is also important. Now let's see if we can find that probability. We can find that probability when we have x being exponential t. So we're asking this question, given that x is bigger than, say, t0 certain time, what is the probability that x becomes bigger than t plus t0? Okay, so what is the probability that somebody lasts more than 85 years, given that his age is already 60, say? Given that he is 60, so... Okay, so let's see if we can find this. So each one of them is an event, right? E given F. So by that basis formula, that is F given E, P of E, divided by P of F, right? So that is P of X bigger than T0, given that x is already bigger than t plus t0. That's this one, right? Times p of e, x bigger than t plus t0. Over p of f, which is x bigger than t0. Okay, so, what is this? That somebody lasts more than, say, 60 years, given that he has lasted more than 85 years. What's the probability that he has passed 60 years, given that he is more than 85? One. So that's one, unless you're in science fiction territory. How about this one? This is calculated that. Remember that was e to the power minus lambda t. So this will be e to the power minus lambda times t plus t0. What is this? This is e to the power minus lambda t0. So it is, in fact, if you divide this by this, you will get e to the power minus lambda. Okay. So what does this mean? What have we found? So let's go back here. So we have found that this probability is in fact e to the power minus lambda t. But what was e to the power minus lambda t? Remember, that was in fact a probability that x was bigger than t. Right? So what does it mean? What have we found here? So, in fact, it means that no matter where you start, it's like starting at zero. So let me explain this. So if I say P of X begin at 85 was like 25 plus 60, right? Given that X was bigger than 60. That is probably that this guy lasts more than just 25 years. That's it. So it seems that the, say the process has forgotten that this person is already 60 years old. It's just saying, for me, it doesn't make any difference. I just find the priority that he lasts 25 years. Even if he's at this point, he is 40, 30, just born, I don't care. I just find this priority that he lasts 25 years. But you might say this doesn't really apply. I mean, if somebody has is now 60, this should be more than when he's like just born. But this is what we say that the exponential distribution is memoryless. So X is in fact memoryless. You see this thing in fact means that it is memoryless. And it comes from the formula. I mean, it comes from the formula, the way that they have defined exponential distribution, it shows that it is memoryless. Yeah, we have to ask people who do actually what this really means for them. But anyway, for us, that's all it is. Okay, so I guess that is exponential distribution. I just wanted to talk about this. Now, next, I will discuss Poisson. Process, and this exponential distribution appears at 2. Okay, so see you next time.